According to the World Bank, you know, by 2030, cities are going to produce more than 80% of global GDP. You know, more than 70% of people will live in the cities. You know, in China right now, the cities generate more than 80% of the total carbon footprint. And also, I think city is really the center of lots of the economic activities, social, political. It's a sort of unprecedented era of the urbanization development that gives us both opportunities and also challenges. China traditionally is a rural country, but that has changed during the past 30 years. We have moved about 500 million people into the cities. That has created lots of challenges, congestion issues, you know, pollution, transportation, you know, living standards. China is trying to complete the urbanization process in 30, 40 years, whereas in other countries, they have gone through about 200 years. We hear of all the smog issues that happen in the three sort of main focus areas in China, the Jing-Jing-Ji, Beijing-Tianjin area, the Yangtze River Delta, and also the Pearl River Delta. I think garbage is definitely another issue. Water certainly is another issue. But one of the very interesting initiatives Chinese government has taken is on this low carbon city initiative. So in this pilot program, the government helped the city set up a target in terms of the total carbon footprint of the city. And then there's various ways to help city to achieve that goal, from reindustrialization, through city planning, through transportation, through you know, low emission buildings, and also all the way to people's behavior, like what we call the green consumption, you know, green supply chain, you know, behaviors. But I think we have a golden opportunity in China right now, because there's a place called the Xiongan, which is 100 kilometers south of Beijing, that where China is trying to build a new capital, or a sort of a sub-capital of Beijing, trying to channel out some of the sort of existing functions of Beijing so that Beijing can get less populated, less congested. And I think that's a basically a plain piece of paper for us to start from scratch and do some really good planning and, you know, integrate all these different ideas together. I mean, that's where yesterday afternoon we had a session on the fourth industrialization, urbanization, in which the head of the Planning Academy of China basically said, you know, this is really the opportunity and probably the only opportunity for us to demonstrate that. And once that can be demonstrated, because that is going to be the sort of the plan. But you know, clearly, the next 10 years is really critical. But I think if we can prove that works, then we can spread that idea to other places.